Hello everyone and welcome to the online lecture series by Sheth Vidya Mandir English High School and Junior College of Science and Commerce. Myself Jayesh Rajgore and today we are going to study 12th Standard Economics New Syllabus Chapter Number 1 Introduction to Micro and Macroeconomics. As you all know my dear students, in the previous lecture we studied in detail about what exactly micro and macro are. As you all know now, micro and macroeconomics are the two branches of analyzing or studying an economy. Micro is about the small millionth part of the economy and macro studies the large economic aggregates. Thus, micro means small and macro means large aggregates. Today, in this video, we shall study in detail the definition of microeconomics and some important features of microeconomics. So, let us begin. Yes, define microeconomics. My dear students, according to Professor Kenneth Boulding, microeconomics is a study of particular firms, particular households, individual prices, wages, income, individual industries, particular commodities. Students, this question can be asked in your board exams for 2 marks. Definition of microeconomics. This definition clearly states that microeconomics is about individual. It is about particular products. It is about particular industries. Here, we can see that there are many firms in the economy. But microeconomic study only studies particular firms out of them. Similarly, we also have many households. But microeconomic studies only particular households. It studies individual industries out of the industrial sector and analyzes them minutely. Similarly, there are many commodities in the market, but microeconomic study helps us in analyzing particular commodities. So, the definition by Professor Kenneth Boulding says, microeconomics is a study of particular firms, particular households, individual prices, wages, income, individual industries, and particular commodities. So, let us now understand the features of microeconomics. My dear students, here are some important features of microeconomics, namely study of individual units, slicing method, partial equilibrium, limited scope, and microscopic approach. Let us now study them in detail. Study of individual units. As we all understand, micro means small. And thus, it is not going to study the larger aggregates. So what does it study? It studies only individual units. Microeconomics is concerned with the study of economic behavior of individual units like households, firms, industries, and markets. In other words, it makes microscopic or in-depth study of individual economic units and not the whole economic units. Let's move forward. The next point is slicing method. My dear students, microeconomics uses slicing method for in-depth study of economic units. It divides or slices the economy into smaller parts. Yes, it is quite understood that microeconomics is not about large problems or nationwide problems. So what it does exactly is, it slices or splits or divides the economy into smaller units such as individual households, individual firms, etc. for the purpose of in-depth study. Moving further, we can see the next point is partial equilibrium. Equilibrium here means a measuring tool which helps you in balancing or understanding the allocated resources in the economy properly. Equilibrium is acting as a measurement tool which helps you in analyzing. And thus, here we have partial equilibrium analysis. Macroeconomic study uses general equilibrium analysis where everything is generalized. But here in microeconomics, partial equilibrium analysis is used. It means the measuring tool is a bit partial. Microeconomics makes partial equilibrium analysis and thus is based on assumptions, ceteris paribus, which means other things being constant. As we move further in this chapter or as we move further in our syllabus, we'll study many laws of economics, which will help us in understanding these constant factors. Moving further, the next point is limited scope. My dear students, as we understood that microeconomics is study of individual units about small and particular things, and thus it has limited scope. Microeconomics studies in detail about the behavior of individual economic units. It examines the trees and not the entire forest, so it has limited scope. So here we move towards the next point, microscopic approach. As we saw in the previous points, every point explains us how exactly microeconomic study helps us in understanding that it is ignoring the larger aspects and trying to study individual aspects in detail. This point assures the same. Microeconomics takes a microscopic view of the economy to study how it works. That is, it studies the function of the economy in terms of behavior of the individual consumers, producers, firms, markets, and industry. So in this way, here, my dear students, we complete all the important features of microeconomics. Meet you in the next video. Till then, stay home, stay safe, keep learning, keep growing. Thank you.